the answer must come from the Muslim community itself, because is this good for the wider Muslim community? No, it's not. And they see it everywhere. Their countries are being torn apart. The whole global community can't operate like this. Who knows what's going to happen if they get into the weapons of mass destruction. But it's difficult for the... It has to come through a consensus of the whole Muslim community itself to say, no, this is not authentic. And I think there are many Muslim voices saying that very strongly. But we in Australia need to hear them. We need to understand where they're coming from and the significance of what they're doing. It's difficult for Islam to respond as a community, because Islam has no pope or central authority in the way the churches do. It doesn't have a clergy the way we have a clergy. The Islamic scholars are recognised because of their scholarship, and they earn their own prestige because of how well they do that. And then they're listened to. But what is happening now is that the Islamists are saying this is an emergency situation. We can't listen to the scholars anymore. They don't know what's going on, and it's up to individual interpretation. So they are assuming the role of making an authoritative declaration. It is very unusual in Islam to see that sort of thing. My final comment then is, we're not... It comes back to a struggle for social justice. If the Muslim community can see that their communities too are advancing in the way of social justice, of human well-being, human rights, all these things we take for granted in this country, then that is the fundamental issue. And we must deal with the grievances of the Muslim communities, particularly in Palestine, but not just in Palestine, genuinely feel. They are real grievances, and they've been allowed to run too long.